Well, big congratulations to you. And he'll be moving on to the next match to face WWLOS. And the winner of that match moves on. Crip, you had a chance to sort of watch that from the sidelines. What'd you think?
I didn't catch some of the amusing parts, apparently, but the last few moments there were pretty epic.
Yeah, super exciting. Yeah.
Super exciting. I'm kind of glad for some reasons. You know, you want to see Reynad go through. For other reasons, you want to see Oskaka go through.
Yeah.
You know, better player or.
Whoa.
So it's, you know, whoever wins, it's a good show.
Yeah.
And that's what we're here to produce for you guys. So. Still going great. I'm very glad that WWLOS went through because I am pretty excited to see some of the flavor he brought to the tournament.
Yeah.
And I think Reynad is a player who tilts a little bit when the flavor owns him.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm hoping to see some of that.
Yeah, well, we are going to move on to that matchup in just a little while. We're going to give Reynad a chance to sort of cool down a little bit. Yep. And get refocused for his next matchup because it's going to be definitely a tough one. So we've talked about Reynad quite a bit over the last matches he just played. But WWLOS, he's sort of been stewing over there in the player area, watching the matches and sort of getting back into things. And do you think that watching those matches might affect him at all? Maybe make him confident or scared, frightened perhaps?
I don't think we're going to see another game like that last one for a while, hopefully.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It was pretty fun to watch, though, but... Yeah, I mean, if anything, he was probably, like, ready to play, and then that last match went to fatigue, and it's kind of like, okay, you know, I can wait. But, you know, it is interesting. We kind of talked up WWLOS as the underdog of the group, but he is the one coming down from the winner's match.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He was able to defeat Oskok in the first place to get there, and like Crip said, definitely has some flavor in his deck, some interesting tech choices. We'll have to see if they can get him through the group, but I don't think, you know, when we use the word underdog, we use it pretty loosely. It's, you know, I think he definitely has a really solid chance against Reynad. And, yeah, I'd like to see what he can do.
Yeah.
I also don't think Hearthstone at this point is really much of a confidence game. I think you just kind of know how to play the deck or don't.
Yeah.
Yeah. So even though he might have some confidence after that, I think it's going to make very little difference.
Yeah, well, Reynad actually hit on a lot of great points that it's hard to sort of recognize when you're actually in the booth playing. He said right. You can't see both hands, so you don't have all the information.
Right.
So sometimes a play that might seem better to us doesn't seem better to him, and he was sort of right in that regard. But another thing that he was mentioning was he'd never played the macro game against Rogue. He never gotten to that point where there was a turn that didn't play itself. And that's where sort of that deck is tough to play, and people say, oh, it's the best deck. You got to bring that deck. Sometimes, maybe not so much.
Well, at the same time, you know, we got a chance to talk with a lot of people, and there is a pretty big consensus that Grim Patron Warrior is the strongest deck out there, no doubt. But at the same time, the difference of play from a player who's played it so many times compared to one who's either not very good at Hearthstone or not played the deck is one of the biggest differences that you can see. So for the average player, it's actually not very impressive deck at all, but for one who's, you know, great at Hearthstone, great at the meta, knows exactly what's going on and can play several turns ahead of time and practice the deck, then it's really a powerful deck.
Yeah.
And other times, you know, yeah, that.
Yeah, that. Well, let's see what we've seen so far in Group C. We're a little less than halfway through the day, I do believe, but we're getting to that sort of deciding match of Group C, WWLOS versus Reynad. The winner moves on to the playoff stage and joins Roger from Group C. The loser is out of the tournament.
That's right. Joining Oskaka. Mm-hmm. Kind of sad.
Yeah.
I think Oskaka was the favorite of the group, as Reynad mentioned.
Or Roger.
I think Roger.
You think Roger was the favorite?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I would have pinned him as that. I think Oskaka might be... He definitely does really well on ladder. He's actually third in European BlizzCon points purely through ladder.
Okay.
Yeah, which is like an accomplishment. Like any tournament player will tell you, tournament players get a lot of points that ladder players
huge advantage from invites.
Can't get.
Yeah.
And so for Oskaka to be number three with only ladder points, obviously behind two people who have gotten tournament points.
Right.
That's pretty good. But you know, some of that doesn't translate to tournaments, especially in such like short, you know, he had two matches to prove his skill, and he's used to playing, you know, month-long seasons
where
if you lose, you know, it's just another loss. You just keep going.
Think maybe this performance was intentional, so he could keep all of his points, ladder points, just to BM his
just
way
to
into the Blizzard finals.
Don't know about that. I think Oskak would have loved to, you know, take a lot of weight off of his shoulders.
Yeah,
and
of course.
Move into that number one spot, even maybe. So a little unfortunate for him, definitely. I think, you know, he had higher expectations coming in. But sometimes
the match
it happens.
Is about to get started here.
Yep.
We see Reynad has locked in Warrior against WWLOS's Warlock.
Yeah. Sort of a 90% traditional handlock, 10% Leroy combination.
Yeah. Do you think Reynad is playing Warrior just because, you know, he kind of like figured a few things out and doesn't want to forget them?
Probably. It's fresh in my mind, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good point. Most likely
true. Like, I did this last game. Yeah. Not again.
A lot of that's true. Momentum plays a big deal. It's the difference of... so it's a statistic that we went through in the regular season weeks of the Legendary Series is most of the players, 3 out of the 4 weeks, the players that automatically qualified for the semifinals that had to play less games lost in both semifinals on weeks 1 through 3.
Yeah.
Because they weren't warmed up. They weren't sort of playing throughout the whole day. And so the people that were coming in that had to play more matches already were warmed up with their decks. They were ready to go.
You're just kind of in the mindset. Like.
Exactly.
Yeah. I had a little word with WWLOS just running across each other in the back end. And he's just really happy to get like the first game, his first match done. He was like, oh, weight's off, you know, feel good now, play better.
Yeah.
And that's certainly true.
Yeah, last season, myself and Silent Storm, we both lost in our groups and both defeated the 2-0 people out of groups. So the people that kind of got to cool off both lost.
Yeah.
One thing that I want to mention here that I think it's still pretty relevant is that I think Reynad's going to focus a lot on his play, and he may kind of forget the wild options available in the handlock of WWLOS. Like Leroy and Power Overwhelm, that's not like something you really play around. I mean, he was playing well, but, you know, he did get countered by a regular handlock, but this is, like, super wild.
Yeah, this matchup specifically, you might be in more of a spot where, you know, you don't really have to play around that as much because the game's pretty much, like, decided you're the aggressor, they're the defending player.
Right.
And so you don't have to worry about, you know, much of a counter offense, especially as a warrior with armor. He's very non-likely to go super low. But
what do you like here? This is an interesting turn. Do you like Owl, maybe, to deny the start of the draw? Because draw is kind of like momentum in this deck.
Yeah.
If you like cut it off the start, you might just have nothing.
Well, you don't get too many Owl targets, to be honest, in the Patron Warrior deck. It's usually Acolyte is, I guess, the best one. Sometimes you can Owl a Frothing. I did hear from Kit Kats who played a Frothing out on turn 3 against Handlock the other day, and I called that, you know, a pretty strange play. Most people save them for a big OTK. He was saying that he and Zalay had started doing that, and they actually got the idea from playing against weaker players on ladder.
Okay.
They just kind of, like, play their cards out, you know, don't know what they're doing. They're just like, Frothing, 3 mana, turn 3, let's go. And it crushed them every time. And they're like, we should start doing that.
Yeah.
They did, and it's something, you know, that immediately seems to be kind of a strange play, but turns out to be great.
So in the end, they weren't weaker players. They knew what they were doing all along.
Yeah, you just play the big card, hit the face. That's how you play Hearthstone.
Those were all the guys on Reddit that are stuck in rank 25 because they're unlucky.
There's a lot of guesswork that you gotta go through with these like very difficult to play decks.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, there's a lot of like trial and error in how you, what your best way to win is. Especially, it's kind of funny how if something's the best deck, finding the best way to win with it is still kind of weird because when you get a line of play that wins 60% of the time, you're pretty willing to take that. But sometimes there's even better choices.
I think the Drake beats the Giant here just because you can, if anything, you can tap Giant next turn.
Yeah.
He's really tempted to try to start clearing stuff.
Mortal Coil, Dark Bomb.
Dark Bomb and Mortal Coil are both very efficient here, but and your opponent kind of has a Death Bite out.
What do you think about Drake and then just coining the Mortal Coil to finish off the 3-3? Because the 2-1 is going to die on the attack anyway.
Yeah, that would make your giant cost 5 still next turn. Okay, just gonna go for the Dark Bomb.
Alright.
Doesn't want to allow him to set up too many plays early on.
The
take
giant
too much damage.
Is also weak to Big Game Hunter, which he knows Reynad has in his list after that last game.
Oh, that's an interesting card there.
Happens to be in his hand, right.
Yeah. Do you go with the Grim Patron here?
No. Too weak to Hellfire, I think. Mm-hmm. But... Yeah, I don't know.
I don't see that much of a better option, so...
Also, your opponent can go Watcher, Goin Shadow Flame. So he's just going to go soft on it. He's not going to Enrage it.
No. Another potential advantage of... You mentioned the BGH play. He knows he has it. The advantage of going from the winner's match instead of coming from the loser's match is you get to sit down on the couch and watch all the matches of the player that just won. So you get
struggle
to see all the three decks in their entirety.
But at the same time, WWLOS was pretty unfortunate in the way he revealed his cards.
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is actually going to work really well for Reynad for the time being. He could Enrage his 3-2, make another 3-3. Make another 3-3, and now he kind of knows there's no Hellfire.
Yeah.
You probably don't go too all-in, but you can draw quite a few cards
here. There's that Shadow Flame. Like, it's...
Yeah.
If you go all-in, you're going to lose, actually, I'm pretty sure.
No, because he doesn't have anything to Shadow Flame.
Mm. And he's got Battle Rage to
refill. What I'd probably do here, it's really unfortunate that Reynad's at 30. And I think that actually goes back to he decided to armor on turn 2.
Which is bad sometimes.
Yeah, he'd much rather be at 28 here. Mm-hmm. So he could Battle Rage for 2, which isn't insane.
Do you like the Armorsmith? I feel like you'd want to...
The Armorsmith doesn't do too much. I think he's going to Battle Rage.
I think a Commander, no?
No, I'd save it, because you really need to pull off like an OTK turn. Against Handlock.
Yeah. The Warsong Commanders and the Frothing Berserkers are sort of your tools to actually win the game.
Yeah, and now next turn, he's threatening a lot, and now, he should get it. Yeah, he got it.
Okay.
That would have been tilting if he missed that. But...
It is kind of funny, like, it's... All these cards have, like, ridiculously long animations. Grim Patron and Sludge Belcher. Those are, like, the two notorious ones.
This could actually be game over if WWLOS doesn't either Healbot or... Like, if he... I doubt he's just going to play Emperor. But if he did that, he would lose. If he doesn't taunt or heal, he loses.
All right, so going through his head, he's thinking, if I play Thorazan... I'm at 16 health. I'm staring at 10 damage on the board.
Yeah, he would need to have 6 from hand.
6 is not that hard.
6
would be a Deathbite and a cool Taskmaster. Would be 6. A Deathbite and an Inner Rage.
Yep, and Cruel Task with Warsong and a Patron on the board represents 7 damage.
Yeah.
So Warsong, Cruel Task is 7 extra.
Yeah. Crazy stuff.
Yeah.
So how does he maneuver through this one? He can use Cruel Taskmaster to start building up these patrons, but again, the Warsong Commander is such a critical tool for later in the game, closing out games against him.
Come on, that's still a crazy amount of damage.
It's not lethal.
Yeah, because he's got to throw at least 2 patrons already into the...
You can break through and leave yourself with 2 patrons if you go Taskmaster on one of your guys, or you leave yourself with 3 patrons, actually.
2...
You Taskmaster one of your guys,
and
trade
you
in the 3-1.
You can get him to 4. To 4, I believe.
To 4?
Yeah.
Is that a good idea, though? Well, he didn't play the Warsong Commander, so there goes that plan.
Yeah.
Yeah. How could he get him to 4?
If he had played Warsong Commander...
If he played Warsong and just went all...
Still, that gives him 3... That would have given him... Only 5 extra damage because 1 patron and the 2-2 would have charge. So you can give him
patrons.
To 11.
2 patrons.
No, only 1 because that last one would have had to run into the 2-3 anyway. So yeah, he could have 8 extra damage. So you could put him to 8.
Hmm.
But he wouldn't have ran into the 2-3 anyway. And there's the Shadow Flame. And suddenly...
He stopped the first wave
Yeah, there is a second wave.
There's immediately a second wave.
And there's a BGH, which is rough. But Reynad's out of draw cards, which is really important.
Mm-hmm. He's used one Battle Rage, and now Battle Rage is not going to be that great because he's got 10 armor and he hasn't taken a damage yet. So yeah, that's one less card that he's going to draw from the second Battle Rage.
Battle Rage is actually maybe the worst draw in his deck right now.
Yeah.
It does nothing.
I think whatever he's going to play is going to have floating mana. So yeah.
He's just going to struggle to kill his opponent now. This is where Handlock just kind of dances around, plays heals, plays taunts.
The way to win is sort of to use that first wave to get out the removal and get through the wall, well, and then use the second wave to kill. Like, instantly. It has it happen simultaneously.
The best way to win this matchup is to either use a Frothing Warsong combo or to Warsong with Patrons and Inner Rages. Because an Inner Rage is 5 damage when you have a Patron out, so yeah. If you Warsong Patron, Inner Rage, that's 13. You add a Whirlwind, that adds like 9.
That's so pretty decent.
Goes
here,
up to 22. Yeah, like I was talking about, all he really needs now is the Inner Rage.
Well, hold on. No. Is there a lethal option here?
Don't close. Think so.
Like, if the boom bots work towards the warrior's favor,
the maximum amount of boom bot or grim patrons you could possibly get would be 4.
I don't think you're in a desperation situation if you're Reynad, so you don't go for like a 5% lethal if there was one.
Okay, actually,
maybe you do.
Well, no, there's a potential because he has whirlwind as well.
Well, you could run the 1-4.
Like this needs to hit the existing Grim Patron for 1, so you can whirlwind off the old one.
If both of these boombots hit... Okay, well, there it goes.
Well, I was thinking if it hits one of them, if it hits the fresh 1-for-1, then he could whirlwind. He's also roping this turn. This is getting dangerous.
Wow. Those boombots were vicious.
Did he attack with the...
No.
No. So he missed an attack. He's probably going to miss one more, maybe? No, he's going to trade.
It would miss an important one here if he did.
Yeah.
I think he got that.
He got it for sure. The end turn went green.
Okay. Woo!
But if your opponent AoEs here, which he's going to, how do you win?
You're out of cards!
Yeah, I don't think there was, like, a chance of lethal there, really.
All right, so if you put both... If both Boombots hit the Grim Patron that...
Because, okay.
Healed for 1.
He was at 16. Right?
He could have had 5 Grim Patrons because that would be all the room that he had on the board. So it would have been 15 damage. That was the maximum.
And that was what he needed.
Unless one. No, because he wouldn't.
But the Armorsmith and the Warsong take up a spot.
Yeah, so.
And
he would have had exactly 16.
No, but you need to get 5 Patrons attacking.
Oh, yeah.
And you can't because one of. Yeah. Because to spawn 5 in the first place. Yeah. I don't think there was any chance.
I think there was.
Chucky,
you're here. I don't think there
was. Chucky, me and Crip are just really thirsty for lethal.
I know
you're just here
are.
To keep us grounded.
How can you spawn 5 attacking patrons to the face?
Yeah.
That's the question.
I think you need ridiculous boombot RNG.
Okay, so you could spawn
and you only
4.
Attack one boombot.
Wait.
You just do the first attack.
No, you could spawn 4 because, okay, you just play it in Whirlwind. Spawns 1. The boombots both spawn 1. That's 4 attacking ones to the face. But that's only 4.
Wait, Chalky, I think this is lethal now.
Oh, I see.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you can lethal your own Grom. Sick.
Sick.
I cannot do that.
Oh, looks like he's pretty not happy.
Mm-mm. That pretty much sums up the past, like, 30 minutes.
Yeah,
even when he won, he was just...
I mean, Reynad for the past, like, hour has just been getting trounced with Patron Warrior, and he came out with a win, too, in the last match.
Yeah. I think the deck is beating Reynad more than Reynad is beating his opponents.
Oh, man.
I think I got it with the Grim Patrons. The Armorsmith attacks the Boombot. The Boombot hits
But then you
the
need
Grim
6
Patron.
Attacking Patrons, because he was at 16. So the Armorsmith needs to hit the face, too. All 6 minions need to hit the face.
Are we there yet?
TJ and Crip are not going to get this lethal off me.
No.
I guarantee it.
No, I think you're right.
Okay, we did it.
You get him to 1. Best case, you get him to 1.
You could get him to 1.
Yeah.
Which would do nothing. Well, he had a Grom, I guess.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, even if that was the best play for some reason... Like, if that was his best percentage of ever winning the game, I still don't think he'd go for it, because how do you find that exact sequence?
Well, okay. The game's starting to get a little bit interesting.
Yeah.
Because there's not much AoE left.
He top decked the commander, which is very important. Now, if you're WWLOS, I think you definitely tap.
Yep. See what you get. More options.
And the question here is, what do you silence? Do you silence anything?
That's nothing.
No, it doesn't do anything.
I think
you're definitely belching. And what do you silence?
The Froth Berserker.
Right.
Because it represents more potential
both patrons,
damage.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah.
And now what can you draw for Reynad?
Last frothing.
Yeah, that'd be pretty good. He can push through 4 damage to face. But then he's running out, and he already used Rom. Still has a chance. Oh, wait.
Yep.
Really?
Yeah.
You just value trade here?
Value trade.
How? Why?
He's got nothing left.
He's got nothing left.
What, the Warlock?
The Warrior.
Yeah. I was about to say, yeah, you just Hellfire. I'd even tap. I would tap Hellfire.
I think
Hellfire.
I would tap too, yeah.
Yeah, your opponent's out of charge damage. Both commanders, both, or Grom. Mm-hmm. Not both Grom, but.
Yeah, there's two Grom?
Two Grom?
That has to be lethal.
So. And again, Battle Rage, like, normally is kind of like your miracle out here where you draw multiple cards, but
Battle Rage is actually
the worst.
Absolutely
draw.
Terrible.
Yeah.
I think the last time he called the worst draw, I think like a Fiery War Axe may have been worse. He had nothing to do
so
with
there
it.
So there is a Faceless in the deck.
Yep.
Okay. Important information if WWLOS makes top 8.
Okay. Well, there is a chance that Reynad wins this.
Yeah.
Yeah, now not tapping makes him not dead to a weapon, which is pretty irrelevant.
But even if he...
But a weapon would probably still kill him.
Yeah,
unless he top decked the taunt.
Well, he doesn't. He has execute now, so he's going to have to trade this in.
Yeah, he's going to make another
AD,
though.
Oh, yeah, with the Faceless.
Yeah, at least one more.
Yeah, if he draws a taunt or heal, I think it's over.
He's still got a few 8/8s left.
That's game.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so hard to make up that lost damage.
Reynad doesn't have 15 damage in his deck.
Doesn't? I think he has one more Warsong Commander and one more Frothing.
He's out of Warsongs.
He has a Frothing.
Well, there's a Frothing.
Yeah.
Well, no Warsongs, though.
Yeah, but what if WWLOS is playing a Mechanical Yeti and gets a spare part?
What spare part?
Stealth. For the Frothing.
Then it might be lethal.
I have no time for okay.
I like the way you think, Crip. Always looking for the outs.
Yep.
I really want to see the Battle Rage draw.
The icing on the cake?
Aww.
Nope. Let the pain
speak to me. Reynad just fishing for information.
He missed the end turn button. There you go.
Everything going wrong for him.
I think there's some argument to just steal the Acolyte.
Okay.
Just take it.
Yeah.
Crip's the creative thinker of the group.
Why?
Give him a card.
I like how he's playing around Brawl now. He's just slowly... He's going to fatigue Reynad out.
He wants to kill
him
with Leroy.
He's
going to
fatigue the deck that can OTK for 50 damage out.
He wants to kill him with Leroy Power Overwhelming. Faceless is what he wants
to
do.
Yeah.
Ah, no, he doesn't.
Oh, now we're going to Faceless. Okay.
No, that's kind of bad.
Yeah, he could have taunted the Watcher as well.
Yeah, that's kind of strictly bad.
Well, it doesn't matter.
Deathwing.
Deathwing.
It wouldn't even matter with Deathwing.
No, Deathwing would be insane.
All right, Kinsey comes out.
No, Saman.
And, it's Saman.
Yeah.
All right, well, WWLOS is going to take game number one. And Reynad, once again, falls in the first match.
Look at that.
Hasn't faced him in the past, though.
Stone cold killer.
Mm-mm. Oh, a new page in the book of Reynad.
Dear diary, I need to practice more patron warrior.
Yeah.
To be honest, that game was
just pretty rough for
rough
him,
draws.
Actually, yeah.
Yeah. That one was
like all jokes aside.
Yeah, he's starting to get the hang of it a little bit, it seems. He played pretty well. A couple of turns where he roped, he actually made the most optimal play in the situation. Yeah. So
now on the other side of things, WWLOS's handlock deck seems pretty cool. Seems similar to some of the handlock decks I play, that's you just make Handlock a bit worse by throwing in some Faceless in there.
He hasn't even used any of those cards.
Yeah, he used the Faceless to copy a taunt.
It didn't even matter.
The Ancient Watch.
Yeah.
It was cool, though.
Sure.
It was cool.
Real cool.
It was real cool.
Just like the Feign Death Hunter, which we haven't even seen the Feign Death in a mulligan.
We actually know the combo now. You guys realize it's you play Emperor Tharsen and you get like a discounted Leeroy Power 1 with Faceless.
Yeah. We knew that.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, Crip.
We were aware of that.
Okay, good.
Thanks, Crip.
I'll go away now.
Now, Crip, you're the creative thinker of the group.
Yeah.
You got to stay here. How else am I supposed to spot lethal?
Would you say this Feign Death Hunter, it's like the dragons in Game of Thrones? You're just like, it keeps teasing you, and you're like, come on, let's see it.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see what they can do.
Oh. What do you think about the Feign Death Hunter against the Grim Patron Warrior played by Reynad? Who takes that?
I think Feign Death's so bad in that matchup. But,
if that was a quick shot, that would be a great deck.
Okay.
We'll put it that way.
Maybe he does have quick shots in there, I hope. But probably not.
All right, moving in to game number two of the decider match for Group C. Of course, just to remind you guys who are just tuning in, the loser of this match is out of the tournament. The winner moves on to the playoff stage. So lots on the line for these players.
Yep.
WWLOS, a new player coming in, making it through the open bracket, going up against Reynad, who had a really tough matchup against Oskaka, but ended up taking it in the end. And it's going to be Druid versus Patron Warrior.
I'm hoping he gets a Fairy War Axe and gets absolutely wrecked.
Well, he's keeping Deathbite, which is even worse for him.
It's awesome when it happens, isn't it?
Yeah.
Crip's out to get Reynad.
Crip's just dropping bombs.
Crip's like, man, I hope Reynad gets the worst draw
here
ever.
Here comes Fairy War Axe right here.
Yeah.
Ah, damn it.
Reynad was trying to...
It's just like... Yeah, I like to see people... It doesn't matter that it's Reynad.
Okay.
I just see, you know, Harrison Joe's an Innervate and a Warrior on the other end.
Sure. Mm. So you want them to go turn two axe pass?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wouldn't that be awesome?
That'd be pretty awesome. But
I think we have different definitions of awesome.
That was an error, says Reynad. Maybe trying to mind game him into thinking he has battle rage. But I think I talked about this with some people. We said if you think you're gonna get, you know, damage pretty soon, threshold of about 3. Then you should attack, you know. But Reynad probably happy to be at 29.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Probably won't draw the battle rage, you know, no justice and all.
Yep. But still win.
You know, in his case, hopefully.
It's a pretty easy Deathbite, isn't it? Because you play Deathbite and the Dread Courser.
You don't really need to coin it out though. Like you might want to save the coin.
Save the coin.
Because like, what do you do the next turn then? Okay.
Another Deathbite.
Okay, you attack. Let's say that'd be a sick Harrison.
Yeah, Harrison kind of blows right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, the silver lining is probably going to play another Deathbite and leave it at 2 charges one of these days.
All right, so the Patron Warrior is on 4 mana next turn.
Oh,
there's
no.
There's not too many power plays.
Oh, I don't like that at all. Right.
Yikes.
Do you like that? I don't like that.
No.
He had to do something this turn.
I think swiping the 3/3 and killing the Armorsmith is pretty good.
Okay.
That would have led into the full charge Deathbite, at least.
I think
it
one
probably
of
probably would have.
Yeah.
One of the reasons why the Harrison Jones is so good in this matchup is because, more so than other weapon classes, is because you can ruin power swing turns where you get rid of the Deathbite when you know they're setting up for something big. His next play was turn 4. He'd already used the coin. What is he going to play on turn 4 that's going to make a really big board with 4 mana?
Well, it's kind of like an instinctive thing. And sometimes you give your opponent too much credit. You're like, okay, they coined out a Deathbite pretty quick. They have a plan. Like, I should disrupt that plan if I can.
Yeah, WWLOS the head shake.
Yeah, and now WWLOS...
What could have been?
He realizes he's like, you know, I don't know.
I could have had 2 cards.
He basically got played, like, you know. Now his opponent's in an even better spot.
You don't know what to do. I think Keeper's actually better than Sledge Belcher here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're really afraid of walking into... you have 2 Keepers, so he's okay. Belcher can be a liability. If he gets patron next turn, he's going to be devastated, but
so you're saying
we know there's no patrons.
So you're saying he's worried about playing Sludge Belcher because of the possibility that patron spawns next
turn
just
and he can
just run it into the slime?
Yeah, it's just going to die anyway to the Deathbite, and I think here he's like he hero powered because he doesn't want to give his opponent a good Deathbite swing, but Reynad didn't want to swing anyway because he doesn't have a patron.
Yeah.
So it's almost like WWLOS is like overthinking it. I wouldn't say that, but he's playing
like,
around the worst case.
Yeah,
and the
I
worst
feel like
case WWLOS
is playing a bit strangely in this match.
The second Deathbite definitely, yeah, like you said, got a little head shake out of him.
Mm-hmm.
Not happy, and you can see he's like gone through all his cards. He's like, "What is this? Like,
yeah.
Where are my good cards?"
Do the card flick.
Yeah, the card flick, the rage card flick.
Yeah, it's like what Magic players do. They always
you're just like
shuffle through your hand.
Yeah,
I think swipe's okay here.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd say good.
It's okay.
There's no good. There is no good.
It's relatively reasonable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or, better yet, it can be used.
Yes.
It is a usable card.
And it is used. How about that?
All right.
Grip, you're like a genius.
Not exactly. I mean, just look at the hands. All junk. Like, if you wanted to play a Sludge Belcher, you just play it a last turn.
Mm-hmm.
So you just rule those out.
Yeah. And he's going to have to play into it eventually. Like,
yeah.
Whoa. Actually, that's not that great. He's reducing one piece of the
combo.
No, it's
pretty insane. It's just a 5-5.
It could be better.
You could kill.
Okay, TJ. You don't like the off-the-top on Curved
like,
Orison.
You could kill like any two creatures for zero mana now.
Yeah, if you can do damage
I think
to them.
The main thing here is there's no way to kill it.
Yeah.
That's why it's so good here.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, two Savage Roars.
And it's not like you're not going to play it.
Yeah,
is this the same deck?
Yeah, I told you, probably two Savage.
Okay.
Yeah.
Two
Makes
Savage,
sense.
One Forest, and then
probably
he sacrifices
one forest
to be able to put in some of the taunts.
Yeah.
Yep. Makes sense. He might have to just silence Thorison, which doesn't even do much.
No.
Like you were talking about, it's not that big that he reduced those pieces, but WWLOS doesn't know what pieces it reduced. He's sitting there thinking that's going to get another activation, but besides that would be way too weak of a play. I agree. And now comes the point where Reynad groms.
Inner Rage is lethal.
Inner Rage, almost anything's lethal. Or no, he needed Inner Rage because he only has 7 mana.
Yep.
He can do 19 to his opponent.
Seems good to me.
It seems good to me. Is Whirlwind double execute. Your opponent has to remove your entire board
that's it. Yeah,
I think I'd even use an execute. No. Just like remove answers,
protect the board. How is he gonna do with a 4 health Thorsen plus the Grom on the board as well?
Yeah,
Savage Roar helps.
BGH first of all
is
in your mind.
BGH swipe could punish you.
BGH removes the Grom off the bat.
Yeah, but even if he like BGH swipes, which would be like the most efficient way to deal with the board, he still would have been at 1 health.
So this is fine too. He still has an activator for Grom and the Whirlwind for free.
And the Grom.
Or the execute for free.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the Grom. That most important.
And it costs 6 mana.
Yeah.
Yep. Looks like Reynad's gonna take this.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, the Warrior pulls out a win anyway.
Gonna get that win out of the way.
I think Mage is the main weak point, though, for Reynad.
Really?
Yeah.
He's having a lot of
trouble. I think even with lack of experience on Warrior, the deck is just so strong. But like you said in that interview, where that was the first game the deck didn't play itself to a win.
Yeah.
Like, that's just the fact of the matter is that Patron Warrior, despite having some tough games where you really have to think, a lot of the games are just like, well, here we go.
Mm-hmm.
I'll play these cards. Good game.
Well, he is going to survive
unless
Reynad comes up with a few extra points of damage.
Fiery War Axe would do it. Cool task. Inner Rage. This is actually a really smart play by WWLOS, by the way. Like, if he's going to stabilize, this is how it's going to happen. And I mean, if you're Reynad, I feel like...
Mind if I roll me?
I feel like there is some merit in just gromming them there, but
4/9 still pretty powerful.
Here come flashbacks.
With so many taunts, it's like taunt. That damage is never going through anymore.
If WWLOS had one more mana, double taunting would be insane here. But
The stabilization begins.
Not yet.
Oh,
that's
my
it.
Gosh,
Inner Rage does it.
Yep. All right.
You can even BM with an Armorsmith if he wants.
I think at this totally point he just wants to get out of the game as quick as he can. All right.
Actually, though, WWLOS was like a turn away from kind of stabilizing.
Yeah. Because he has a lot of taunts left in the deck, let alone the two other Sludge Belchers.
And that was one, the last execute.
Yeah.
Wow. That was a lot closer than it looked.
Actually, if he chose to play the Belcher instead of the Druid of the Claw, he wouldn't have died.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Wow.
All right. Well, Reynad is going to tie up the series 1-1.
I really feel like WWLOS could have done a lot of things different. No, not like one big thing, just a lot of small things differently. And I think quite a few of them may have ended in him winning.
Right. He didn't think too long on a lot of his decisions there. Mm. And I mean, obviously wasn't in the best state of mind after the insane start Reynad had. Like, everything goes Reynad's way. He has both Deathbite. He top decks Emperor on 6. You have no answer. Like, wow.
Yep.
Reynad still has the Hunter remaining and, of course, the Mage, which he's been, despite all the excitement with Warrior, the Mage has been the deck that he's been struggling with the most.
I think Mage against Hunter and Druid, though, is pretty okay.
Those are two of its best matchups.
Yep.
Especially this Mage. If you get even just a decent start against Druid.
I think especially this Hunter.
Especially this Hunter, yeah.
Because Feindeath Hunter really relies on you developing some sort of board, and Tempo Mage kind of shuts that out, or loses to itself.
We keep talking about how it's Feindeath Hunter, but in reality, it's just a Hunter with one copy of Feindeath.
And a
Sylvanas. Are we sure of that?
Yeah.
And a Sylvanas.
We've seen enough games that it's just pretty standard mid-range Hunter with a Feindeath.
Okay. Yeah.
And a Sylvanas.
Yeah.
It's kind of neat. I think Bo is actually pretty good at this matchup.
Yeah, I think it's two decent hands from both players. I really like the Flame Cannon.
Yeah, it deals with all the animal companions, which is pretty common.
Just really works with Mana Worm, too. Like, Mana Worm just takes care of the garbage, and if it's not garbage, Flame Cannon deals with it.
Wow, WWLOS.
Pretty good start.
Whiffed on the 1/2 drops here with this opening hand.
Really good start for Maynard now.
Yeah.
Portal, he's got the spell synergy in the right place.
Another Piloted Shredder, a useless draw.
Well, it's going to be like the Hunter's on defense.
Yeah,
he has
to coin out the bow, or else things are just going to steam out of control.
Yeah, of course. I think that's what he planned to do anyway off the bat. The trap's not too bad. He might have to kill Command next turn to run.
You're right, the Drake is a big deal because those cards may not do anything. Like, Flame Cannon just might hit nothing. And then Unstable Portal might just produce nothing.
Mana Worm the deck.
That's pretty sick.
Yeah.
See what he gets? Esports?
Nope.
Ooh. I think he's going to play
it. Counters Unleash.
He's going to play it. It doesn't really counter Unleash, even. It dies to the three dogs.
Yeah.
And if you can just kill it before you unleash.
You get less dogs.
It so does counter Unleash.
You would unleash and then run all the dogs in. You're at like the perfect amount of minions on board where it sucks against Unleash. Normally it counters up.
Gotcha, Chucky.
Setting the Hunter record straight.
I think you actually play it.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Is like you just eat the damage, I think. Like, and it protects your mana worms in a sense. So
Web Spinner.
I think this is the Unleash.
Oh,
because you have Web Spinner Kill Command next turn if you want to. So I'd unleash and then bow off one of the mana worms. But he's definitely thinking about a lot of different stuff. I think one of the main considerations, though, if you've played against Tempo Mage a lot, is cards like Flame Cannon, where if you go for a development plan, which you really can't do right now anyway. You're very likely to get tempoed out, as the deck name suggests, where they kill your stuff, keep hitting you in the face, you get really low, and then they burn you out. Whereas if you just play removal for a while, like you said, Crypt, their hand can get stuck with cards like Flame Cannon.
Yeah.
But just going to Freezing Trap one of the Mana Worms and develop the Whip Spinner.
Not much in terms of good options. I mean, you had this play, you had Kill Command and Mana Worm, you had the Unleash. I mean, they're all kind of whatever.
They're all pretty mediocre.
Yeah.
And,
Oh, actually, this turns out to be the worst one, because now Mirentity comes down and there's no Whip Spinner left.
Yeah.
It's going to have to hand him over a pile to Shredder unless he draws something a little more insignificant. And there's also the possibility, of course, that he might feel like he needs to check for Counterspell.
Well, if he was watching games, he'd know there's no Counterspell.
Did we rule it out, though?
We ruled it out, because he had two Mad Scientists
now. Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
And they both died, and he only got one Secret.
Why do you think he's thinking so much? You think there's actually an option to play another Mana Worm? Oh, I guess he's thinking about not hitting the Web Spinner. Okay.
Whether to trade or not.
I think that's what he was thinking about. Okay. And you might as well think about that during your play rather than play the Mirror Entity and then debate it.
He's going to see if he can get a Captain's Parrot.
That's pretty interesting.
It's like a 70% chance to get a Captain's Parrot, I believe.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. 70? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep.
Oh, you have some paper there. I'm sure you've done the math.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, right here.
Wow, that's a lot of math.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's like so far today, which I think is a big enough sample size to conclude that this statistic is real.
Oh, so sorry.
80% of the time it's Misha.
I think you just play that still. Oh, God, Ranger. You get tempoed so hard by Flame Cannon.
Yep.
Yeah, I think this game's over now. Go to 12. Oh, you used the one off the top. Oh, missed tilt.
Yeah. Actually, do you? I think you don't. I think you used the one you had in hand because now you could have, like, anything.
No way. You tilt.
It's all about the tilt.
Hard.
Okay.
Oh, he top deck Flame Cannon. That's why I lost.
Of course he top deck Flame Cannon right
after
I played a 4-4.
Knife juggler.
Yeah. These have to be the best.
That's a pretty good card.
These have to be, like, the best juggles ever.
Yeah, but Hunter doesn't have much stabilization. Like, I guess he plays Belchers, but what's...
Looking good, yeah.
Yeah, he gets to...
That last one, not so good, though.
I think it's fine. I would kill the Mana Worm, probably.
Yeah, I think killing the Mana Worm is more, more tempo.
You have to value trade.
More
there.
Tempo.
But you're taking... Well, actually, no. You're potentially taking more damage to the face. But there could be more with the Mana Worm, because if he has spells...
He has three spells, it's more.
Hey.
Oh.
Oh, man.
Oh. Yep, getting tempoed. See, look, he would have played both Flame Cannons anyway. Mm-hmm. Should have tilted him.
All right.
Reynad has not taken a single point of damage so far
from
this game.
From a hunter.
From a hunter. Now, granted, it is a feigned death hunter.
That didn't quite hit the face.
Well, like, there's no way there's any healing in this deck we haven't seen.
Yeah, he better be feigning death. Okay, because if he's actually dead, that's pretty bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, he is pretty dead.
There's nothing you can do. Like, okay.
You actually have nothing you can do here.
No, you can. You
look,
can,
his hand is over the escape button right now.
You can play a piloted Shredder.
And get Vitality Totem?
Yeah.
Oh, we got him 2 damage!
It's not a perfect game after all.
He's close!
Mm-hmm.
14 more of those. Crossbolt would be lethal. But.
Exactly, yeah. Oh no, it'd be one over because of spell damage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He'd have the Flame Waker.
Yeah.
Waking his flames. Alright.
Oh, he went for the quit button.
Oh!
Well, yep.
Alright, well, Reynad is actually going to, on the first try, take a win with that mage.
Yeah.
So all of a sudden, Reynad's one win away from securing a spot in the playoffs.
But it's not only that, it's his third deck. It's actually the deck I missed him play.
Yeah, I said it'd be the weak link.
Oh, it is Hunter.
But once I saw kind of the matchups, you know, going into that, it was either Druid or Hunter.
Mm-hmm.
Both pretty good matchups for that mage deck.
Yeah.
And now it's Hunter versus Hunter and Hunter versus Druid. I think he can easily win one of those.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially since his Hunter probably has a little bit more of consistent matchup in the mirror.
He had Abusive Sergeant, so... Little bit more damage heavy, which is pretty nice.
Yeah. Is it? I thought like the face versus the hybrid, doesn't the hybrid usually win?
Well, it's not really.
It's the opposite.
Yeah, but Reynad's not face hunter. Mm-hmm. He's just like mid-range.
Well, it's like closer, you know?
Yeah.
It's closer to mid-range than it is to face because he runs Powder Shredder and Sludge Belcher.
Well, it's just like WWLOS has like the slower Hunter deck.
And look at WWLOS. Uh-oh. He does not look happy.
Is that a prayer?
Could be.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
And, you know, to be honest, that's how he's looked the whole day.
Mm.
Well, he looked pretty happy when he was winning.
Yeah, yeah. When he won his last match, he smiled a little bit. He seems like a pretty relaxed kind of guy. He's been hanging out over the past couple days. He's been talking to people, but it's always he's just really chill, you know?
Kind of been laughing about, like, you know, Reynad's trouble with matchups and stuff, but he's actually on the upswing. He won his last match.
Yeah.
WWLOS lost his last match.
Yeah. Yeah. We've talked about the inconsistencies of that Temple Mage deck that he brought, but that last match he sort of
just crushed it.
Yeah, hit everything spot on, and that's strength.
That's a feast or famine deck. Like, when you win, you crush.
Yeah, you really win. It's one of those decks that you really don't have fun playing against.
Yeah.
It's a not crushing fun. Defeat or crushing victory.
Yeah, you're just like, what was that deck supposed to do?
Yeah.
You either feel bad because you crushed them, or you feel bad because they crushed you.
He just got rid of everything. What's he looking for? Wild Growth? Wild Growth Innervate pieces? What? Whatever he's looking for, he didn't get, because it couldn't have been those cards.
Oh. If he doesn't draw a Wild Growth or an Innervate, he's in a lot of trouble.
Innervate with Emperor turns out to be really good. And Reynad, like, senses blood or something, just instantly coins Juggler, which I tend to really like, especially when you have a pretty mediocre hand. It's one of the ways you can win.
Yeah.
Innervate makes the hand quite a bit better, but Reynad does
not
have a play.
Much better.
Against non-Hunter, Innervate here would be like really huge and maybe put him in the lead. But against Hunter, especially the coin to Juggler, you're just really going to take a lot of damage.
Yeah, and Freezing Trap in the opening hand is actually really strong against a lot of, well, some classes. One of the most especially is Druid, because they make a big Innervate play. All of a sudden you play Freezing Trap.
Yeah,
it's just they have like nothing to freeze. Like the two drops of a druid are removal and acceleration.
Yeah, the best
just
you can
a snap freezing trap.
Best you can do is like force of nature and freeze one of the treants, but that doesn't come to way later on.
Yeah, or a little bit later on.
Mm-hmm.
Sped it up a little bit.
Just a turn. Yep.
Yeah, you can pass here. You only attack if you actually think Reynad is bluffing there. Oh,
that's a hopper!
Wow. And the dagger face went juggle. Face, which is pretty important.
Yeah.
And the Houndmaster next turn, and nothing to do. Literally nothing to do.
Out of 12 total animal companions today, two of them have been Huffer.
And
isn't that 70%?
Is it? I don't think so.
It is pretty sad when your tournament run kind of comes to an end to this kind of game.
Yeah.
For Reynad, he's just happy that today he's going to be over with.
Yeah. Is it over? No, he's got Force of Nature.
It's not over. He's going to be going really low with no taunt in hand.
It's just
going
to be so hard for him to get back
low
in the game.
Yeah.
He can heal up next turn with Ancient of Lore, but there's going to be almost enough damage on the board to just make up for that.
So he's going to maximum trade to remove damage.
Mm-hmm.
And look at that curve.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, like, how do you win? This is one of those draws you just don't win with.
Mm-hmm. Ancient of Lore.
You heal for five, yeah, and then
oh,
you trade.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, being behind one card and so much life is not going to work. There's just no way out of this
right.
one.
Right. Like, Reynad's hand would have to be absolute garbage. And it's
well, a few of the cards are pretty garbage.
Not enough.
Yeah, not enough.
Especially with Kill Command off the top, one of the best cards.
Yeah, he hesitated a little bit there because if he unleashed Kill Command, that actually would have been...
two off.
Yeah, two off lethal, so... Make sure
and
don't play too fast.
That's it.
Yeah, there's really not much you can do here. He can stay alive with double Wrath. Or Wrath? No, he can't treant. Okay, so he's still alive, but...
Not really.
Reynad just kind of smirking, like, good luck.
Good luck. You dealt with the high main here.
You're going to need it.
Have a Dr. Boom.
I like the slight hesitation. He's like, maybe there's Baron here. Nah. This cannot be wrong.
Yeah. Can't even use the wild growth to try and cycle for something.
That's going to be game.
And the concede comes out, and Reynad earns himself a spot in the playoffs.
Yeah.
So how far do you think he's going to go?
Oh, man.
His play is only going to get better.
Well, he got
actually,
second
that's true.
Seed.
I think tonight, Reynad has
I think he
has
gets
some practice in.
He gets time to like just recollect himself, and
I think like
yeah, it was only really that one game.
Is like 3-4 hours good enough?
Like we've exaggerated this a lot, but it was really just that one game.
Mm. Yeah.
So
yeah, overall,
yeah, it doesn't take much. Like just sleeping on it is usually enough to reset your mind.
Okay, that's good.
WWLOS cannot be disappointed about his performance.
Yeah.
He played really well across the matches that that he played today. He ended up winning a match, and he brought some really creative decks, which is always something that Crip, you said before, something that you always advocate
great.
For.
From like a viewer standpoint, it's just it's very important to like see something new every time. Mm. Sometimes it's a new play, but with the Conquest mode being so so dominant in the tournament scene and with few decks being so dominant, expectations to see cool new stuff is pretty low. So when it happens, you get a smile.
Yep.
Hmm. Yeah, so Reynad is going to move on to the playoff stage. He's going to join Roger from the group, who he actually lost to in the first round of today. Mm-hmm. So
We've yet to see their opponents, though. We're going to get to that shortly here.
I think a lot really is going to matter on what matchups it gets, especially for that mage deck. Yeah. Like we saw the Druid and the Hunter were really good matchups for it. So he had no trouble winning within that last match. Yeah. So I don't think it really comes down to like who he faces, just like the decks, really.
Yeah, what he faces.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, just kind of how well each player metagamed.
Yeah. Well, Froden is standing by with our winner of that last match, Reynad, on the stage. So let's see what he has to say.
All right, Reynad, you did manage to get to the top eight, but you don't look entirely too pleased with the entire outcome, all things considered. So what's going through your head right now?
I just wish I played the series against Iskaka better. You know, hopefully I play better tomorrow. Yeah, before the match with WWLOS, I didn't feel like I was drawing or playing that well, but it like was barely enough. So I think that, all things considered, like I picked a good lineup for this, so I'm happy with the deck choices. And yeah, it seemed to work out. I mean, the last two games weren't really games, but that's Hearthstone. So, yeah.
Did anything change for this series at all? Because, again, to be able to come out barely out of that series previously is sometimes unsettling, but it seemed that you rebounded excellently. And then, like you said, the draws end up panning out much better this time, but you still also played well. Did anything change in those 10, 15 minutes that you got to reset your head?
No, I mean, there's just some games that, like, because of the way two draws line up, one player can't lose, and in that case that was me. Like I drew double Mana Worm in a matchup where tempo matters, and Mana Worm is like not only the best card in the deck but the most important card against Hunter. So like I had two of them. I drew like the Sorcerer's Apprentice, the Unstable Portal. Like everything about that game was just so unlucky for him. And then like, well, it wasn't so much unlucky for him, it was more like lucky for me. Like he had the bow too, his draw wasn't bad, but that's a matchup also that like I'm gonna win most of the time, but not like that convincingly. And then the game against Druid, he went, like, he didn't have the answer for Juggler, which in and of itself, right? I draw Juggler with coin. He doesn't have the Wrath or the or he has the Wild Growth, but so he has to go for the Innervate play, but then I naturally have the Freezing Trap. It's like, it's not that he made the wrong plays. It's just like, it's one of those games where the way it lines up, when both players make the right play, like, one player just gets farmed, which is what happened, so.
That's right. Of course, farming players is what Reynad does. You have one more match tomorrow, to at least guaranteed. That means you do have to show up in the morning, tomorrow morning. Are you going to be able to get some good night's rest tonight so that way you can prepare for tomorrow?
I'll try my best, Dan.
All right. I'll make sure he does. That's my job, too, as the host and the manager. And that'll wrap up Group C here. And congratulations again to Reynad and Roger, as we will have two more players going through. Unfortunately, Iskaka and WWLOS, they'll have to try again next season if they want to become the Season 3 champions. And with that, we're going to go to a quick break, I believe. And so we're going to head straight to the desk and see what they have to say about our upcoming Group D matches.
Thank you very much, Dan. And once again, congratulations to Reynad. Of course, we'll be seeing him tomorrow. Yeah. Next up is going to be some matches from Group D. But due to time constraints, we had some issues earlier on in the day. So
yeah, we played out the original sets.
Indeed.
We've played in the backstage. We already had Life Coach versus The Rat. Mm-hmm. And we already had Silent Storm versus Phone Tap.
Yeah, so Life Coach, of course, took a 3-0 victory over The Rat. He moves on to the winner's match, which I believe will be the first one we broadcast. And then, of course, Phone Tap took a 3-2 victory over the Season 1 Legendary Series champion.
How about that?
Silent Storm. Yeah. So those should be some exciting matches. Do you have any predictions going into that one, Chucky? Who do you think is going to come out on top on Group D?
I think Life Coach is definitely the favorite of that group, coming off a huge win at Via Game. And as far as second place, I honestly think it's up in the air. Obviously, Phone Tap's in great position to move out of the group.
He got
two win and ends. So does Life Coach. So it's hard to put any stake into the two people that have already lost.
Yeah.
But I know
that's a huge deal.
Yeah. The Rat and Silent Storm, both great players. Like, I know a lot of people have talked up The Rat. I don't know much about him. I just met him this weekend. But, you know, I know he puts a lot into practicing this game. And it would be pretty bad for him to go out 0-2. But Silent Storm also, you know, no stranger to winning, won last season. This is probably the most stacked group of the tournament. It's hard to call.
Yeah. But you, Crip?
Yeah, I'm pretty much chucking this one. Okay. If you want a game, it's basically bigger than any other advantage you may have.
Yeah. All righty. Well,
by a landslide.
The conclusion of Group D, and thus the conclusion of the group stages, will continue after a commercial break. But don't go anywhere. Plenty more Hearthstone Legendary Series Season 2 Finals action right after this.